Firstborn Ministry, bringing the infallible Word of God to the world.
You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Let us pray. O God, our Father, we now release, Lord, this word into your hands. We bind the powers of darkness, that your children's heart, God, will be open to receive as thus saith the Lord. Let your words through my mouth and the meditation of our hearts, let it be acceptable in your sight. O God, our strength and our Redeemer. And God's people will agree and say, amen. Amen and amen. For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness in this age,
my Lord.
Against spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places.
Yes.
Therefore, take up the whole armor of God that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand.
Yes, yes, yes.
For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war according to the flesh.
Amen.
For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God.
Amen.
Pulling down strongholds.
Yes.
Casting down arguments.
Yes.
And every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God.
Amen.
Bringing every thought into captivity.
Yes.
To the obedience of Christ Jesus.
Yes. Amen.
I am here to warn the church of God that there is a battle that is ensuing.
Yes.
Against God's people.
Yes.
From time to time, we're going to experience.
Yes.
Yes.
We're going to experience a lot of trials and tribulations.
Yes.
We are going to have a foe that consistently fights against God's people.
Yes.
He is going to play a lot of havoc in the lives of God's children.
Yes.
And I'm here with a message and a word to get the church of Jesus Christ and everyone else who will listen to this word.
Yes.
That you must not be caught off guard. We have a real enemy.
Yes, yes.
And because of that, a lot of folks from time to time, once they go through trials and tribulations, and sometimes the Church of Jesus Christ, they pray, they do everything according to the Word of God.
My Lord.
They are obedient to the Word of God. They consistently give back to God what He says you should give back. You submit yourself to the authority of Almighty God.
Yes.
And yet, my God, every day you face a battle.
My Lord.
You're truly in a war.
My Lord.
And sometimes, my God, from time to time, you might even consider to throw in the towel.
My Lord.
You sometimes have thought that, you know what? I don't think I can go any further.
My Lord.
But I am here to tell you
My
to
Lord.
Hold the fort.
Yes, amen.
Hold the fort.
Yes.
And that is what I will entitle this message today. Hold the fort, because the battle is not ours,
yes,
but it is for the Lord.
Amen.
The battle is already won.
Amen.
Yes.
I will turn your attention to Job chapter 1. And from verses 6 to 12, we will now see where a man of God, the word of God lightens this man to be a perfect man. A man who honored God Almighty,
yes,
who loved God and was very obedient,
yes,
to Almighty God.
Yes.
And you know what? As I read the word, I realized that the more you love God, is the more you're up for trouble.
Yes. Yes.
I will say that again.
Amen.
The more you love God, is the more you are up for great trouble.
Yes.
Because every child of God who is obedient, from time to time, God is going to boast about you.
Amen.
The devil in hell consistently would like to really accuse God's people.
Yes, yes, yes.
He presents himself, the word of God confirms. God was having a meeting, and there the devil comes right in. He's not fearful to present himself before anyone. If he has the nerve to present himself before Almighty God, then who do we think we are? The word confirms that now there was a day when the sons of God came to present themselves before the Lord. And Satan also came among them.
Lord.
And the Lord said to Satan, "From where do you come?" And Satan answered and said, "From going to and fro on the earth, and from walking back and forth on it." Then the Lord said to Satan, "Have you considered my servant Job? Have you looked at the man, Job, that there is none like him on the earth, a blameless and upright man, one who fears God and shuns evil?" And Satan responded to the Lord and said, "Does Job fear God for nothing? Have you not made a hedge around him, around his household, and around all that he has on every side? You have blessed the work of his hands, and his possessions have increased in the land. We'll but now stretch out your hand and touch all that he has, and he will surely curse you to the face." And the Lord said to Satan, "Behold, all that he has is in your power. Only do not lay a hand on his person." So Satan went out from the presence of the Lord. Satan was given the authority to inflict the possessions of Job, because God wanted to show him that Job's love was not because of what his blessings were upon his life. That it went deeper than the blessings that God had blessed him with. And the devil in hell, from time to time, accuses God's people.
Yes.
You have to know that from time to time, if you live right in the presence of God, that he's going to be accusing you. He's going to use folks against you. Folks who will look at your life and want to condemn you. And their lives are not even near the life that you live. But that's how the devil works. He has his little demons, and they are very busy And he has the authority to use some folks against the people of God. So God's people must understand that the devil is for real.
That's right.
He presents himself as if he is not a real demon or the real spirit. But believe you me, my God, he can create a lot of havoc in the lives of God's people. He inflicted everything that Job had. He actually went and was able to destroy whatever God had blessed Job with. And we continue in Job chapter 1, and I'm sort of building up this message so that we can see how the devil works.
Yeah.
From verses 13 to 22, excuse me, and we're still in Job 1. Mm-hmm. And the word of God says, now there was a day when the sons and daughters were eating and drinking wine in their oldest brother's house. And a messenger came to Job and said, the oxen were plowing and the donkeys feeding beside them. When the Sabines raided them and took them away, indeed they have killed the servants with the edge of the sword. And I alone have escaped to tell you, be careful of these messengers who come to you.
Yes.
Be careful of these messengers, because the devil was able to kill off everything that Job had, but what he did, he speared someone to bring the bad news to Job.
Yes.
So I'm here to warn God's people about those folks who are always coming with a message. While he was still speaking, another also came and said, the fire of God fell from heaven and burned up the sheep and the servants and consumed them, and I alone have escaped to tell you. While he was still speaking, another also came and said, the Chaldeans formed three bands, raided the camels and took them away, yes, and killed the servants with the edge of the sword, and I alone have escaped to tell you. While he was still speaking, another also came and said, your sons and daughters were eating and drinking wine in their oldest brother's house. And suddenly a great wind came from across the wilderness and struck the four corners of the house. And it fell on the young people, and they are all dead. And I alone have escaped to tell you. And when Job got all these bad news, Job arose, the word of God says, and tore his robe and shaved his head. And he fell to the ground and worshipped God. And he said, naked I came from my mother's womb, and naked shall I return there. The Lord gave and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In all this, Job did not sin, nor charge God with wrong. And I just love that word.
Yes.
I love that word, because I like when the devil accuses God's people that they can remain true to Almighty God.
Yes, I'm putting to
shame. That they must stand firm on the faith.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Their faith in Almighty God.
Amen.
Knowing that God is a God who gives all things, and if he allows them to be taken away, then it's all right. That he has a way. That there's nothing that comes to the child of God unless God has given the devil some authority to attack.
Yes.
I bless God for
that. Amen.
Because I know that I'm not by myself.
Amen.
I'm not alone. And we can learn from what happened to Job.
Yes.
That the devil had to go to God and to get permission. The devil acknowledged that I can't touch him because of this hedge that you have. And God had to give him that authority.
My Lord. My Lord.
had to give him
yes
that authority
yes
to touch
amen
his servant
amen.
So when we are taught much about human suffering through Job's experience, what is indeed profound is we are taught that even though Satan is in rebellion, he is very much accountable to Almighty God.
Yes.
And I give God thanks
yes.
for that.
Amen.
That no matter what he does and flares up and want to roar and think he's in charge
yes.
and in control,
yes.
he is still accountable to Almighty God.
Glory.
In the story of Job, Satan remained true to his name by accusing Job and afflicting him with all kinds of suffering.
Mm-hmm.
However, Satan's power is not equal to God's.
Amen.
Although he attempts to hamper God's work, he is still and will always be limited by God.
Amen.
And even though he may wish to be a God himself, Satan remains answerable to the commander in chief.
Glory!
Hallelujah!
Glory!
The commander in chief, the King of Kings,
my Lord,
the Almighty God.
Yes.
The most important thing is that he cannot do anything to a child of God who walks according to the Spirit.
Amen.
Without gaining permission from God.
Amen.
Because God actively restrains yes. Satan.
Yes.
And promises that he will not allow us to be tempted beyond what we can bear.
Amen.
And that is in 1 Corinthians 10 and verse 13. We can then be confident that by God's power, we can overcome this wicked foe, that great impersonator, that accuser
yes.
of God's people.
My Lord.
Resist the devil.
Yes.
Resist him.
Amen.
And he will flee
Amen.
From you.
Amen.
Let him know that you're aware of yes. your heritage.
Amen.
Let him know that you're aware that God is with you.
Yes.
And that he cannot test or go beyond the limits of Almighty God.
Amen.
And he continued with the attack on Job's body.
Hmm.
He went back again and he presents himself before God, just as the people of God did. And if you go to Job 2 from verses 1 to 10, you will see that that account tells you that he went back.
Mm-hmm.
Because he was not going to be satisfied with us just destroying the properties of Job. No, he wanted to inflict Job's body.
Yes.
My Lord.
Because he knows that if he had Job at that place, that the way how Job praised God, that he is going to at some point now be broken down.
My Lord.
When you are rocked in your body with different infirmities, sometimes it's hard for you to praise God. And that's what he decided that he will do with Job, because he wanted to break him down. He wanted to bring him low in the valley.
My Lord,
my
Jesus.
God. And God says, "Go ahead. Go ahead. I have given you the authority to inflict his body." And Satan made well. He made well with that authority that he was given. The authority that God placed in his hand. He says, "Now I'm going to use it with everything that I have. When I'm finished with him, with this man of God, I know that he's going to relent and he's going to now curse God." What the word of God confirms, that the servant of God remained confident. Job 14 from verses 1 to 2 confirmed that. Job says, acclaimed, "Man who is born of woman is of few days and full of trouble. He comes forth like a flower and fades away. He flees like a shadow and does not continue." Job understood the frailty of the human body.
Yes.
That the human body is temporal. And that the human body, once it was marred with sin, my God, that it was now susceptible. It was susceptible to sicknesses, to diseases. But that doesn't substantiate that God, our Father, is not with us.
Amen.
That God, our Father, is there watching over us. That God, our Father, will be strength for us.
Yes.
And Isaiah 35 from 3 to 4 then comforts our hearts when we're going through those sicknesses, that we're to strengthen the weak hands. And make firm the feeble knees.
Yes.
Say to those who are fearful in heart, be strong, do not fear. Behold, your God will come with vengeance, with the recompense of God. He will come and save us.
Amen.
He is there for us, church.
Yes. Yes.
He's not going to leave us nor forsake us. Because he assures us that he permitted no one to do us harm.
Amen.
Yes, he rebuked kings for their sakes, saying, do not touch my anointed ones.
Amen.
And do my prophets no harm.
Amen.
You see, Satan has a certain limit.
Amen.
God limits him, put a limit.
Mm-hmm.
And he cannot go beyond that limit.
Amen.
He wants to make God's people feel as if he is in total control. And once he might have the permission to bring some kind of affliction on us, at some point in time, he has to leave us alone. Glory be to God. God is there for us. He's never leaving us nor forsaking us. He says, no weapon that formed against you shall prosper. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And every tongue which rises up against you in judgment, you shall condemn them. Because this is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is from me, says the Lord of hosts. We give God the praise and the glory that he's in total control then. That he controls everything,
amen.
My God.
Amen.
That no matter what happens to us,
amen.
We can still praise God.
Amen.
We can still give him the glory.
Amen.
We can still worship him,
yes.
To know that he is in total control,
amen.
That he has never lost control,
yes.
My God. For he is our refuge.
Yes.
He truly is our refuge and strength. He's a very present help in trouble, says the word of God in Psalm 46.
Yes.
Therefore, he bids us that we should not fear, even though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though its waters roar and be troubled, my God, though the mountains shake, with its swelling, there is a river whose stream shall make glad the city of God.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High.
Hallelujah.
The word says God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her just at the break of dawn. The nations raged.
Mm-hmm.
Satan raged.
Yes.
The kingdoms were moved. And the earth was melted. The Lord of hosts is with us. Glory be to God. The God of Jacob is our refuge.
Amen. Amen.
He truly is, church.
Yes, yes, yes.
He truly is. So I'm here to send a message to the devil in hell. Leave God's people alone.
Yes. Yes.
I would encourage him.
Yes.
To give it up.
Yes.
I would encourage him to throw in the towel.
Yes. Yes.
Because, trust me, he's not going to win this battle.
Amen.
We do not fight this battle by ourselves.
My Lord.
But the battle is the Lord's.
Yes.
And if God is fighting our battles, greater is he that is in us
than he that is in
this world.
Glory.
Glory be Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah for the treasure of earthen vessels. But we have this treasure in earthen vessels.
Mm-hmm.
That the excellence of the power may be of God and
yes.
not of us.
Yes. Yes.
We are hard pressed on every side.
My Lord.
The church of Jesus Christ is hard pressed. Every day you get up, you're facing a battle. My God.
Yes. Yes.
You're hard pressed, yet not crushed.
My Lord.
We are perplexed, but not in despair.
Amen.
Yes.
Persecuted, but not forsaken, for God is with us.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Struck down, but not destroyed. Always carrying about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus. That the life of Jesus also may be manifested in our bodies.
My Lord.
For we who live are always delivered to death.
My Lord.
For Jesus' sake.
Mm-hmm.
That the life of Jesus may be truly manifested in our mortal flesh.
Yes.
And because of that, so then death is working in us day by day. But life. In you, and that is 2 Corinthians chapter 4 from verses 7 to 12.
Yes.
Hard press.
My Lord.
Yes,
every day.
Yes.
Every day you get up, my God, you face some trouble.
Yes.
Something that you have to deal with.
Yes.
Another menace.
Yes.
From the demons of hell.
Lord.
My God.
Jesus.
These demons are busy.
Hmm. Yes.
They're very busy.
Very.
Church. They are very busy because they know that the time is very short.
Short. Yes, yes.
And
yes.
they're working overtime.
Yes.
They want to get God's people out of the way.
My God.
They want to eliminate the church of Jesus Christ so they think that they can do. But I know that my Redeemer lives.
Amen.
And he shall stand at last on the earth.
Amen.
Amen.
And Job claimed that after my skin is destroyed, even though the devil in hell might destroy my skin, this I know that in my flesh I shall see God.
Amen.
I will see God.
Amen.
Even
Amen.
If he prevails
Amen.
In destroying my flesh.
Mm-hmm.
Because this earthly tent is only for a season. It is temporal.
Mm-hmm.
And God's people must know that even though our flesh is fading away, that we will see God.
Amen.
My God. And by that assurance then, the church, therefore, should strengthen their hands which hang down and the feeble knees and make straight paths for your feet so that what is lame may not be dislocated, but rather it be healed, says the Lord of hosts. Hold the fort, church.
Yes.
God.
Amen.
Hold the fort.
Yes.
The battle is hot.
Amen.
But the victory is already won.
Yes, yes.
Hold the fort.
Amen.
Don't be dismayed. Don't be discouraged.
Yes.
For God is with us.
Amen.
The God is of heaven is our light and our salvation. Whom shall we fear?
Yes.
He is our strength. Who of whom shall we be afraid? When the wicked came against us to eat up our flesh, enemies and foes, they stumbled and fell.
Yes.
Though an army may encamp against us, our heart shall not fear. Though war may rise up against us, in this we should be confident. We would have lost heart, I'm sure. Unless we had believed that we would see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. And God's word assures us that we should wait.
My Lord.
Wait on the Lord and be of good courage. He shall strengthen your heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord.
Amen.
For he who scatters has come up before your face. Man the fort. Watch the road. Strengthen your flanks. Fortify your power mightily. And that is Nahum chapter 2 and verses 1. The word of God assures us that we should hold the fort.
Yes.
The battle is on, but believe you me, it is won already. It is just a short time. And the devil in hell knows that he has a very short time. I even am the Lord who comforts you. Who are you that you should be afraid of a man who will die? Mm-hmm. And of the Son of Man who will be made like crabs? Mm-hmm. And you forget the Lord, your Maker, who stretched out the heavens and laid the foundations of the earth. You have feared continually every day because of the fury of the oppressor. Don't be afraid mm-hmm. of the oppressor.
Mm-hmm.
All he does is war. But all his teeth were already extracted.
Amen.
All he can do is roar and make noise.
Mm-hmm.
But he cannot bite
glory.
On a child of God.
Glory.
And we give God the praise and the glory for that.
Amen.
We give God the praise and the glory for that.
Mm-hmm.
That he just roars at the church of mm-hmm. Jesus Christ.
Yes.
But he cannot ever destroy us.
Glory.
The more he comes towards us,
Bravo.
The more that we are going to go forward.
Amen.
My God, because we know who is the commander in chief.
Yes, 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 yes.
Jesus Christ, our commander in chief.
Yes, yes, yes.
Jesus Christ who leads this army.
Amen.
My God.
Amen.
Jesus Christ. Who is in total control. And the devil in hell knows that.
Amen.
He's aware of our heritage.
Yes.
And he's also aware of his destiny.
Mm-hmm.
Don't let the church, don't allow the devil in hell to dissuade any child of God. Mm-hmm. Don't let him allow the church to cringe.
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't have the authority
mm-hmm.
to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Now to you I say, and to the rest in Thyatira, as many as do not have this doctrine, who have not known the depths of Satan, as they say, I will put on you no other burden, but hold fast what you have till I come. And he who overcomes and keeps my works until the end, to him I will give power over the nations. He shall rule them with an iron rod, that they shall be dashed to pieces with the potter, like the potter's vessel, as I also have received from my Father, and I will give him the morning star. So hold fast,
mm-hmm.
church.
Amen.
Hold the fort.
Yes.
Hold the fort.
Amen.
There's a popular hymn that is entitled, Hold the Fort.
Yes.
And the hymn says, Ho, my comrades, see the signal waving in the sky. Reinforcements now appearing. Victory is nigh.
Yes.
Hold the fort,
praise the Lord,
for I am coming.
Hmm.
Signals the Lord of hosts. Wave the answer back to heaven by thy grace. We will see the mighty host advancing, Satan leading on. Mighty ones around us falling, courage almost gone. Hold the fort,
Amen.
For I am coming, says Jesus Christ, because he signals on. He says, wave the answer back to heaven by thy grace. We will. See the glorious banner waving,
mm-hmm.
hear the trumpet blow. In our leader's name, we triumph over the foe. Hold the fort, church.
Amen.
Hold the fort, for I am coming, says the Lord of hosts. Mm-hmm. Jesus signals still. Wave the banner. Wave the answer back to heaven. By thy grace, we will. Fierce and long the battle rages, but our help is near. Onward comes the great commander. Cheer, my comrades, cheer. Hold the fort. Hold the fort, for he is coming. Jesus signals still. Wave the answer back to heaven. By thy grace, we will. Hold the fort.
Amen.
Be not dismayed. Be not discouraged, no matter what you go through. Don't even consider throwing the towel. The victory is won, my God. The victory is ours.
Yes.
To enjoy.
Amen.
The victory was given to us by Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
So what then shall we say to these things?
My Lord.
If God is for us,
who can be against us?
Glory be to God.
Amen.
If God is for us, who can be against us?
Amen.
Which demons in hell,
my Lord,
can be against the church of Jesus Christ?
Yes, yes, yes.
He who did not spare his own son, but delivered him up for us all.
Yes, yes, yes.
How shall he not with him also freely give us all things?
Yes.
Who will bring a charge against God's elect? Can the devil do that? It is God who justifies.
Amen.
Who is he who condemns? It is Christ who died. And furthermore is also risen. Who is even at the right hand of God? Who also makes intercession for us? Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Yet in all things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am persuaded. I'm persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus, our Lord.
Amen.
Hold the fort.
Amen.
Church, the church of Jesus Christ must hold the fort.
Amen.
Nothing should be able to separate us from the love of Christ Jesus.
Amen.
The battle is already won, church. The battle is won. I am determined that neither death,
amen,
nor life,
my Lord.
I say I am determined that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any created thing shall be able to separate me from the love of God. I am aware of my heritage.
Amen.
And the church of Jesus Christ must be aware of her heritage.
Yes.
That is given to us through the shed blood of Jesus Christ. The devil in hell is a liar.
Yes.
He's a defeated foe.
Yes.
He was stepped upon,
my Lord,
on that day when Jesus Christ said it was finished.
Amen.
On Calvary's cross.
Amen.
And it is for the church of Christ to enjoy this victory.
Praise God.
We are to enjoy this victory.
Yes.
That is given to us.
Amen.
And if we're going to enjoy this victory, then we have to hold the fort.
Amen.
Hold the fort to the end.
Yes.
Run the race,
yes.
My God.
Yes.
Run it to the end.
Yes.
And when you have run the race, then you will hear your Savior, the Commander-in-Chief, saying to you, "Welcome, thou good and faithful servant. Enter into the joys of my salvation." My God, we give God the praise and the glory.
Amen.
We honor His name and we worship Him.
Thank you, Jesus.
We give Him the glory, for He is worthy of praise and glory.
Yes.
Our Commander-in-Chief is in total control.
Yes.
And the Church of Christ, my God, ought to give God the praise and the glory and to be resonated to hold the fort. Hold the fort. Hold the fort. Our Commander-in-Chief has already run the battle.
Yes.
We bless God and we give you praise, Lord God. And we worship you,
Amen.
The King of Kings. We honor you, Lord God, as our commander. We honor you that we are treading behind you. We're walking behind you and you being the chief in control, my God. You're leading your army, the Church of Jesus Christ. We give you high honors and we give you the glory and we praise your holy name in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, and God's people who believe in their hearts and have decided that they're going to hold the fort will now agree and say, amen and amen,
amen
and amen and amen, amen and amen.